Okay, let's talk hay. Briefly, horses work best on grass hay. A lot of people want to feed alfalfa. It's a high-rich food. Alfalfa is not a natural grown. It's man-made. It was designed for horse track people, racehorse people who run the crap out of their horses. They work them to the death, and all they want to do is get a 2 or 3 year old and run the crap out of them and get the most out of them so it can win 1 or 2 races. Then they want to insure it for $2 million, and then as soon as it loses, somehow the horse collect or dies and the insurance company pays off. And that's why I'm not a fan of horse racing. I don't support it. I don't like the Kentucky Derby, none of them. I don't want to hear about how great the horses are and how good the doctors are, and I don't want to hear that. When money's involved, horses pay. And alfalfa was designed for horse racers because they worked the horses so much and so hard and just locked them up, and they wanted a high calorie protein food to feed these horses, and that's why they start feeding it to horses. Now, dairy farmers feed alfalfa to the cows to produce milk quicker. Again, alfalfa is man-made. And here's some alfalfa here. Looks pretty green. Oh, look how pretty it is. It's green. It must be good for the horse. No, it's not. It's flaky. It's stringy. It's got a lot of dust. It comes very hard packed. Doesn't fall apart. And that's why a lot of people like it. You know, I like alfalfa because I can carry a flake easy. And see, Rick, when I pick up a flake of alfalfa, it's solid. And I can just carry it and it doesn't flake away. But if I pick up this grass hay, it's troublesome because it falls apart. And it's not as easy to carry. You know what? That's typical non-horsemanship thinking, behavior, beliefs. It's all about me instead of about the horse. Grass hay does fall apart easier. Grass hay is harder to, is harder to carry, but it's better for the horse. And though it's more trouble for us, like most things are, the right thing is usually not the easy thing. And it's a little bit more difficult to spend time with your horse. It's more difficult to work with your horse. It's more difficult to come out when it's raining and check on your horse. All those things are more difficult, and it's better for the horse. If it was easy, it's probably not the best thing to do. So what Buddy's eating right here, and again, he's got his whole pick of hay in here. He just kind of walked in a little hay barn here. I'll leave it open. He gets to come in and snack. And this right here is an oat rye mix. And you can see the little buds here on this oat hay. And when you talk about a horse filling his oats or being fed oats, that's basically what it is. They take oat hay and they take all the little oats and all these nice little oats off. And that's what the horse likes. I think that's one of the best hays. I like oat hay. Some people say I don't like it because it makes the horse hot. It gives him too much energy. And, God forbid, you know, we want our horse to be healthy and have energy because we don't know how to control him when he's a little got energy. So we'll feed him crap hay so he's lethargic. Or we'll feed him high-protein hay that just gives him a boost when he eats it, and then it makes him lazy. And you can see Buddy came over here and started eating on this alfalfa a little bit because I was getting in his face over there. again, alfalfa, I'll give it as a treat. There's been some studies done that a very starved horse that has been starved and abused, alfalfa will put weight on them quicker. So if you got a horse that's really, really thin and that's really undernourished, then alfalfa has a lot of protein, but it can shock the system. Some of you may be too young to remember, but there was a time in Somalia where we did some aid and we sent milk to all the starving kids because we wanted to help. Because, we wanted these poor starving kids, let's send them some milk. And we ended up killing a bunch of kids because the milk, they were so malnutritioned, they couldn't handle the milk. And when they drank the milk that we sent, it killed them. So trying to help end up killing a bunch of kids, and everybody felt bad, but the kids were still dead. And people do that with horses all the time. I feel bad and I want to help. Oops, the horse died. Gee, I was trying to help, so I guess it don't matter. Well, you're responsible for the horse, and feeding a horse responsibly with good hay is your responsibility. Again, this is a oat rye mix hay. It may not look as green as the alfalfa, but it's about, I'd probably say, 10 times better for the horse. It's more strawy, it's more roughage. It makes the horse chew. A horse produces 12 gallons of saliva a day to produce his hay. And we want to throw him a flake of alfalfa that's hard and stiff, and they want to eat it in 30 minutes because we feed them twice a day, so they're starving. So they eat it fast. They don't chew it. They just take big mouthfuls and swallow it, which causes impaction colic. And we wonder why all these horses are colicking. Next time a horse is colic, ask what kind of hay he's eating. And 9 times out of 10, I bet you it'll be alfalfa hay. Grass hay is a fury. Are you jealous because this horse is getting all this hay? I know you want some hay too, bud. I know. All right, we'll give him a little bit of grass hay here. I know, you're a good boy. So, feeding a horse different types of hay, everybody's got their own. You know, there's timothy, there's rye, there's grass, there's orchard grass. Any grass hay is good for a horse. And again, I like oat. This isn't pure oat. This is an oat rye mix. This right here is a straight rye hay. Depending on your hay, or where you get it is what it looks like, but looks are sometimes deceivings. Just because the hay is brown, that could mean it's just sun bleached. And hay sitting on the side will turn brown. Alfalfa even turns brown, if you notice right here. And if that was all out in the sun, it would all be brown. But that still makes it very compact, a very dense hay. When I pick up a flake of this this rye hay, I can tell it kind of falls apart. And to me, that's good, because when I lay it out, the horse can pick it out, and he eats grass like a horse does. And he can kind of nibble through it, and he's not taking mouthfuls. When he eats this alfalfa, he takes a big chunk like this, and it's solid. And he chews on this big chunk. So if there's a dead mouse, or a rock, or a sprinkler head, or all kind of other things that I find in hay, it's not good for the horse, and they can accidentally pick it up in that alfalfa because it's concealed a wire, a piece of barbed wire, etc. So, we're just basically wanted to brief on hay, different types, what you can feed, what's better, what's worse. It's all personal preference. Again, grass hay is best for the horse. It's best for the digestion. It falls apart easier. It's a little more hard to handle, and you might have a little bit more waste because you drop and lose some, but it's a whole lot better for the horse, and it makes it easier for them to digest. They're less likely to colic. They get more nutrients, and it's not man-made alfalfa hay. So rye, oat, orchard grass, any grass hay, better than alfalfa. So that's a little bit on hay. Hope that helps, buddy. Enjoy your little snack there. And that's talking about hay.